Yo guys, what's up? It's your girl Dev, and today we're going to talk about the 5 biggest questions I get asked, and along with those 5 questions, I'm going to throw in some tips and tricks for you guys as well. This video is kind of late coming out. I've got a lot of stuff going on, both personal life, both with the game, and it's just been pretty crazy. I'm probably going to do a recap video of some of the stuff that's happened, and it's going to be great. But let's go ahead and kick this thing off right. Strap in, guys. Let's go. Okay, so let's start this off right. The first question that I normally get asked, either in Discord, in throughout all of the content creator Discords, and throughout Rise of Kingdom, anywhere that there is a jumper group, I get asked, how do I find out if a kingdom is winning KVK? So let's go ahead and hop right in, and I will show you how we're gonna find this out. You're gonna zoom all the way out of your map. You're gonna hit the globe on the bottom right-hand side, and you're gonna go down to the bottom left, which is the Lost Kingdom Contenders map series. And as you can see here, these are lists of all the kingdoms that are in KVK, or at least available to look at. One thing to note on this is when you're looking at these, the only kingdom that you're gonna get the best reward in is in a season one, because all other kingdoms, KVK requires honor points. It has to be season one. Season one is about 60 days old. I'll have to confirm in the description below on exactly what the time frame is for KVK season one, but it should be around 58 days or so. So these kingdoms have just completed KVK. The kingdoms you want to look at are the ones that are inside the 60-day window, which is this one here. So this one's 48 days old. In about 12 days, these kingdoms are going to go ahead and get those rewards. Let's go ahead and take a look. And remember, in KVK season one, as we're loading in, it's against the own kingdom. What? I'm getting attacked. Let's see if we can go take care of this real quick. Sidebar, I'm getting attacked. I'm in ancient ruins. Oh, that's why. Let's see. Yes. Oh, and a Boudica. Oh, yes, please. Yes, please. These are not going to be easy kills for you. Sorry, dude. Quick sidebar, we have to fight. Oh, this is great. Yeah, I'm here. So as you see here, a little tactic I'm going to be fighting is I do want to get off that Boudica. I do want to take her out, but she is quite fast. So pulling her, I'm too busy running away. So I need to find the army. There it is. So the Alex and Richard, and she's going to end up attacking me anyways. We're going to switch roles and attack her back. Let's see. Let's go ahead and attack her directly. Let's get rid of her. Is that Sun Tzu with her, maybe? No. This is a T5 march. Yeah. So, one of my guys here can help me out. Hit the help button. Yeah, so, little sidebar. I got attacked while I'm making a concert. And we're gonna head back to ruins and see if we get attacked again. I do need kill points. I do need points, so for KVK, and this is the best way, easiest way to do it. I know there's a couple of guys that are still online right now. For me, it's beneficial to go ahead and keep my march in the middle of this big mess of troops and potentially get striked again, and they not strike me, but strike some of my allies and use them as a beat stick so I can go in for the kill. Yeah, see? They're smart, bringing more armies in. Okay, so there's that. That was fun. Right. What does this say? Oh, okay. Let's go back to making content, right? This is sidebar. Alright, so how do you find out if a kingdom is winning KVK? So again, you go back to the Lost Kingdom maps, go all the way down to the bottom. It has to be Season 1. Season 1 is only versus the kingdoms in your continent. I will show you. It's 20 days. Let's see, 48 days. This is perfect. Okay. So 1689 versus all the way to 1696. All of these kingdoms are on the same continent. So we're gonna go ahead and go look again. And what we're looking for is key features. The the best way to describe it, finding the kingdom with the most color on the map. Those are usually the kingdoms that are winning. 90% of the time, they are the ones that are winning. So yellow is not boxed in, so they're probably doing pretty well. Blue is not boxed in. Orange is, so this is the kingdom you don't want to join for rewards. Red's boxed in. Blue looked like it came from one side all the way around. Wow, that's it. Okay, so there you go. We're gonna go for blue. So let's see this map again. This is Lost Kingdom 87. Let's go ahead and take a look at who owns the ziggurat. And it's currently 93 AC, which is kingdom. We go to alliance members. You click on one of their players, hit info, and there it is. 1693 is the current holders of the ziggurat. And you could create an account in their kingdom and potentially ask them for a favor to join the alliance to get a reward and then hop right out. It doesn't take long. Your chances of being part of the alliance at the end of KVK to get those rewards is going to be pretty slim, but if you can get in the kingdom and they're winning first place and they have all the stuff and you can get in for a quick go in, get rewards and come out, that's great for you as an early start. I will be careful though, because sometimes a lot of jumper groups do this and they cause a lot of problems within the kingdom, and then they just say, no, we're not letting anybody in. Keep that in mind when you are doing a jumper account and you're going into a kingdom that is in KVK, because they're focused on KVK. Okay, so let's head back home real quick and we'll go over the second most asked questions. And that one is, how do I prepare for my first KVK? What do I need to do to prepare myself? Well, some of the key features when you're preparing for KVK is your troops. Making sure that you have full marches of troops that you can hold. Some people won't have a level 60 commander, but like a level 50 commander. But having a troop size that will accompany that. So let's see. Let's say that I had Herman, which I don't recommend. I don't like Herman. No, but I'm using him as an example. His capacity is 190,000. It does go up if you're level City Hall level 25. Every time you upgrade your City Hall, it does go up. But anyways, 190,000. I should have at least one march of full archers at 190,000. Having more than that will allow you to have a hospital still that you can go back and refill and still have a full march of 190,000. But you get the point. Having full marches for T4 is great for KVK Season 1. Your average player going into KVK Season 1 is usually 10 million power. I know that for some people I feel like that's a lot, but for your very active free-to-play players, 10 million power by 90-some days isn't too bad, but they have to be really active, being on all the events, potentially being an alliance that's getting all the rewards. Again, there's a lot of contingencies to getting 10 million power. We'll cover that in another video. The other thing you want to do is your commander. Again, going back to the commanders, making sure you have good commanders. I know you're not going to have all these expertise, but having two really solid marches, like a Sun Tzu and a Joan of Arc, which are pretty easy. Sun Tzu should be expertise, and a Joan of Arc in the secondary is not a bad march combo. Having a good cavalry combo would be like Pelagius. And Baybars. I didn't expertise Baybars until late, so I just used a Baybars and a Pelagius and a Minamoto, or Minamoto and Kaukau. There's a couple different combos which you can go for. But having one commander at least that's expertise of each troop type would be really key, especially as a free-to-play low spender player. Your high spender players should really focus on your garrison commanders, your counter commanders, like a good Richard, a good Charles, a Mina, a Kaukau, Caesar, not really sure. I'm not really great on him. He's great for city hitting. That's pretty much it. But a good Charles is good. Friedrich is really good for early game. A Metman is good. Again, going back to city rallies, he's great for that. And an El Cid as well. You're not going to really see a whole lot of him and Frederick. Or actually, you're not going to see a lot of Frederick, but you'll see a little bit more El Cid because you do have the El Cid MG that comes up. And then the rest of them are just mixed in. YSG, definitely a good push for Season 1 Commander because they do great. Like a Charles and YSG in a flag is great because it gives you your counter attack damage reduction plus your AoE effect on why is she skilled when they're expertised? Now, so I covered how you can prepare, which is your having your four marches and your commanders. The next thing is your AP pods and your resources. Having good resources is great, especially you have them here in the token form instead of up here farmable that's at the top. Having good resources is going to help push you and help heal your troops faster. Whenever you're healing troops, don't heal with universal speed ups. Use your healing speed ups, but only use them when necessary, and heal your marches and batches like 2,000 at a time, 2,500 at a time, or even 1,000. It depends on how active your alliance is. Another thing that you want to look at, like I said earlier, is your AP pots. AP pots, that is the biggest thing I get asked, so that's going to be going into question number 4 that's most frequently asked, but following on from 3, save your AP pots for KBK, because you're going to be getting so much more rewards. Let me see if I can pull up a quick picture of some rewards that I got from defeating barbarians. Level 36 barbarians. I'm getting resources, I'm getting speed ups, and I'm getting experience tombs. Plus, I'm getting experience on the commanders if I don't have them all maxed out. I gotta upgrade Charles, but I'm gonna wait to that later. But anyway, so XP is great for commanders. And that leads us into question number 3, which is best events to spend AP on. The best event to spend AP on is, of course, in KVK, because you'll get the Clarion Call event, but you get Clarion Call when you're in KVK, so you're not only getting chests for that, but you're also getting points for your honor points, which is your honor point system is here, and you can track how much honor you have throughout the entire KVK. So it does a 2-for-1. Now, in the pre-KVK stages, it's going to give you parchment papers, and you'll see that card up in the top. If you want to look at my pre-KVK video that talks about AP usage, I definitely recommend when you're in KVK to use between 60 and 70% of your AP usage during an event. I think you're going to have another thing, you have a couple of lower events, those are really good to have. But you can do guard forts as well, barbarian forts. You do pretty decently, and you get honor points for. Please ignore the Soluna coins, because that's only applying to light and darkness, but the rest of it is across the board. So your 9 and 8 and 7 and 6 forts. 5 doesn't give any help for honor points at all, but your 8 and 9 is where you're going to probably get the most bang for your buck, because each march with AP, you get the AP reduction when you do multiple marches at the same time, so you kind of have to stack all of these things. But Barbarian Forts is not really something you want to heavy focus on for AP usage. So those Barbarian Fort sieges that you do in Early Kingdom, that really just shows activity. Who is the most active alliance? They're going to have the most forts done, right? Yeah, so that gauges activity level. Sometimes people feel like it's who's better competition, and they try to outdo the competition, and then you're spending a ton of AP for no reason. Let's move on to number 4, and that is upgrading troops. When should I upgrade troops? Well, that's actually kind of interesting that we bring that up, because upgrading troops is very important. We actually have an event currently in our kingdom that's called From the Ground Up, where you use speed ups to gain more points for the event, and this is the perfect event that you would want to upgrade your old troops to make new troops, because it goes off of minutes and not actual points of the troop, because troop points are different than the minute points. When you talk about the troop points individually, it actually refers to the points just like the Mighty Governor, where the troops are actually worth more when you build brand new ones, because if you just upgrade, then what you're doing is you're taking the difference. So if one T5 is worth 20 points and you have T4, it's worth 10 points, you're only getting 10 additional points for your score and not the full 20. So that's why for Mighty Governor and events that you need to push power, you need to build or create brand new and not upgrade. So that's why in this kind of event in particular, actually upgrading your troops is better than it is to create new ones. Or at least you can use the opportunity to upgrade and create new ones. But it's actually kind of convenient that I have these as well because the Light and Darkness past Glory event, it's actually stage 4 is troop training and it starts tomorrow. And I don't want to push those brand new 20k troops until tomorrow and then also wait until after Kingdom Buff or right at the end of Kingdom Buff to determine how hard I want to push in that event so I can get more legendary commander sculptors. So again, it goes back to this is also having to do with push power, but it also has to do with upgrading your old troops to make new troops. Alright guys, so let's talk about number 5, and that is when do you need to push power, or when can you, or when should you? Now this question will vary between every single player because no two players are the exact same because of either spending level, activity level, or even interest in the game, or familiarization of the game. As I mentioned in the previous question, the From the Ground Up is a great event to push building. It does say training speed-ups, but the building speed-ups, this is more for early kingdoms. Late kingdoms really just have like the level 25 buildings they have to do. With More Than Gems a few days ago, some people are upgrading their castle. This is the time to do it. And they upgrade their castle and they also upgrade their academy, which gives them the T5s, you know, eventually. But either way, you need to push power when you do it. Well, you shouldn't push every event if you're free to play. For me, I'm not free to play, but I am a very low spender. I don't spend a whole lot. So I can only push events that I know that I have a fighting chance to win. This event, I will find out tomorrow when I ask for Duke about 3 hours into the title because I want to make sure that I can, if I push power too quickly, then I just use all of my speed ups for no reason. And as you see in my pre-KVK video that I did earlier, a card up in the top, I did try to push power and push T5. I could have had it, but I didn't because I was nowhere near going to be in first place or even make top 10. So I judged it based on my kingdom. I knew that the reward isn't that great, and I will show you these are pretty generalized rewards that go across all of these events. And that is this legendary commander sculptors. I wouldn't have gotten that many, so for me, it wasn't worth it. There's also an event coming up that a lot of they might or may not do, and this is the one where you compete against other kingdoms and you try to get like the person who increases the power the most. I might do that. I don't know. Oh, my verification. I might do that, and I'm not 100% sure yet, but when I know, you guys will see a video. I'll probably do a live stream so you can see me push T5. Not 100% sure, but I'll keep you guys updated. But either way, again, I'm going to reiterate this. Pushing events is going to vary per person. If you feel like you can win based on your activity of your kingdom and the amount of speed-ups, always you need to count that and count how many days and minutes that you have total. So just keep that in mind. Last time I did the assessment on my current account with my speed-ups, I had 60 days in training, 21 days in research, and 345 days in universal. This was also about 4 days ago, 4 or 5 days ago when I did the math. I know that I have gotten a lot more since then, especially since I've done the Ramsey wheels a couple times. But either way, judge your speed-ups and judge the event in your kingdom based on all those variables. You might be able to win one or two events, but if you are a heavy spender, and you want those legendary commander sculptures, you really need to wait till these events come up so you can take first prize, or you just constantly pushing out technology and you don't even care about these events, but you still push them anyways because you get those free legendary commander sculptures. It's going to vary for everybody. But anyways, that wraps up the fifth question. It did go in depth a little bit more than I wanted to, but you get the point. All right, guys, so that wraps up the top 5 questions that I see getting asked in all kingdom discords and kingdom chats and mails and DM chats directly to me. Now, I do want to mention 2 other small things that I don't feel like are asked enough or people just curious about. And one of those is know your role in the kingdom. So my role in my kingdom is I'm a title giver and I'm on the Diplo team. So I also provide guidance to the king and the other leaders and help coordinate who we're going to pick for KVK, help with events and tracking and things like that. So that's my role in my kingdom. But what is your role? How do you fit into the kingdom? Well, that's a pretty loaded question and it varies per person, because you really need to evaluate yourself. Do you pay to play the game? Do you low spender, or are you just a free to play? And now you have to tailor what you have there based on your commanders and your troop types. If you are a free to play player, you should focus on just having T4 max tech, not T5. T5 is stinking expensive, and I'm gonna unlock it because I do spend a little bit. I feel like I play the game enough and I can make enough resources. I have enough farms. I feel like I can do it, but I'm probably gonna regret it because of the repair costs and the cost to just make them. It doesn't matter, but you need to know your role. Do you fill rallies? Do you garrison? Do you rally flags? Do you ground fight and just open field? So really evaluate what your place in the kingdom is, and that'll help you build your commanders accordingly and troops. And the next thing that I feel like doesn't get asked enough, or at least doesn't get mentioned enough, is don't ever overextend yourself. Now, people play this game like it's real, like they feel like they put so much time and effort in this game, but you can very easily troop zero yourself. And I have done that in the last KVK season 3 card up in the top, because I feel like I did that and I lost over 1.5 million troops that KVK. I didn't have many. I came out of that KVK with only about 400k troops, and that was mostly siege. So really keep that in mind, because that's going to really help you in the long run, especially because it's going to be difficult if you troop zero yourself or even get zeroed. It's really difficult to continue playing. But when you surround yourself with great community and great friends, it's really helpful to you as a player, because it really helps build you into the community and get you really involved and wanting to participate in these events. But enough of that for now. I really hope you enjoyed this video. It was pretty long, but I covered a lot of things that I feel like gets asked and needs to be talked about. If you have anything else that you feel like I didn't cover correctly, or you feel like you would make adjustments to it, or even give better advice, dude, I'm all for it. I make these contents for you guys. This isn't for me. This is for you, my users and my community and my governors and my alliance members. This is all for you guys. All right, so don't forget to like and subscribe to my videos for seeing more content like this and random fighting that I did in the beginning of the video. Pretty awesome. I know it's been a while since I made this video, but stick around. I have so much more coming because KVK is just kicking it up, because we have Kingsland this week and I'm going to live stream Kingsland. So don't forget to like and subscribe to see that right below. And I hope you guys are doing good. So for now, guys, just keep it real.